Once we have created our Django model, which is essentially a table or a description of a table that we're going to build in our database, we then need to go ahead and migrate. And this is essentially the process of taking our Django model and then updating our database with any new information. And in this case, we've created a new model, a new table. So a new table will be created in this instance. So back into our application, inside of our djblogger blog app here, we created our model in the previous tutorial. So now we're ready to migrate, which is, like I said, essentially a process of preparing and then making changes to our database. So this is a two-step process. So first of all, if we go into the terminal here, we need to prepare. So for that, we type in manage.py and make migrations. So by running make migrations, essentially what's happening here, Django is going to inspect all the changes that may need to be made, and then a file is made. So we now have this migrations folder here in our blog app, and you can see that we have this initial migration. So this feature is very much like, for example, a source control, whereby we take a snapshot of the current system, in this case, the current model setup, and then we basically make a script here, or Django creates a script here, which can then be utilized to actually then perform that on the database. Now here in the Django framework, we have the Django ORM, which is essentially the toolkit, or part of the toolkit, which will be able to translate our, which is essentially just Python code, into a language which can then be utilized by our database, so SQL typically. So this is one of the benefits, of course, working with Django, in that we can quickly create applications without the need for us to really interact and have to swap languages and work with the database. We simply just create a model and then run migrations, and then Django will sort everything out for us. So now we have this migration file here, and we can make this ourselves. We can change this if we wanted to. Obviously, we don't want to do that at this point. But once we've done that, we can then go ahead and now migrate. Now, typically, when we run the first migrate, which is the command to actually apply these changes, when we run the first migrate, what's going to happen? Because if we look at our settings file inside of our base here, you can see these installed apps here. Our app that we created isn't the only app that's installed. These apps here are all installed by default when we create a new Django application. Now, behind the scenes, some of these apps here, these features, require database. So for example, the authentication app here, for example, that's going to create a table, a user table, for example. So we will find that when we initially migrate our application, that it will also create all these additional tables. Now, if we were just to run server here, if you remember before, you might have seen this red text regarding 19 unapplied migrations. So that's just referring to the fact that there is tables that these apps need in order to for Django to work correctly, in some cases, that need to be created. For example, admin, auth, and so on. So let's just close that, and let's go ahead now and run a migration. So I'll get my keyboard right in a second. So So manage.py migrates, and then that's going to apply all the migrations. Now it should be successful. So typically, if there is a problem, it will be detected whenever we make migrations. So typically there isn't a problem when we migrate. So now we've migrated, you can now see at the bottom here in our project, we have a DB SQLite database, the default database for our Django project. The SQLite database is a file-based database. It's just one file. You can't open it up if you click on it, you see, but you can access the data. So if you go into the extensions and you type in here SQLite, then we'll be able to install the SQLite extension here. And that will give us access to actually inspecting our SQLite database directly from Visual Studio Code. So if we now go back into the Explorer here, Let's go down to our database and right click, open the database at the bottom. A new option here appears, and we can then go ahead and open that up. It gets a bit messy on the menu, on the view here. And then we can then go ahead now, I can drag that up. We can now go ahead and inspect our database. So this is the database that's just been created for our project. Notice, more importantly, that we have created our blog post table right here. And you can see all these tables fields relate to the fields that we created. Now, one of them doesn't, the ID. So this is a primary key. So Django will create, unless we specify in our model, it will create automatically the primary key for our table. So in our model, we haven't specified a primary key. So therefore, Django has created one and it's called ID. If you're not familiar with databases, a primary key is a unique field that uniquely identifies each row of data in our table. So let's assume that, for example, you've made a mistake and you now want to make a change in your table. Now, what we can do is we can simply just add a new field. And then once you've added a new field, you can go through the process again. And what will happen, you make migrations and then a new migration file will appear. And then you go ahead and migrate, and then that will be then applied to the database. Now, like I was suggesting here, that this migration feature is very much like source control in that it's tracking all the changes that have been made. So here we have a history of all the changes that were made, and this allows us to potentially roll back to the previous state of our tables, for example, and also allows us to keep track of the changes that we've made. So if we wanted, for example, just to reset everything, what we'd need to do, just make sure the server is turned off. We're going to need to just delete the SQLite file here. And then what we need to do is delete the migration file. So that's important. So we're going to reset everything. Now, if you have multiple applications, here we just have one, the blog, you might have, when you migrate, you might have multiple migration files. So you need to be careful of that, but we're just going to delete that one. And there we go. So we've reset the whole application now. So I just need to go through the process again, using up and down on my keyboard, make migrations. There we go. And migrate. And there we go. The database is back to the state it was before we deleted it.